In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create this highly unique paper flip transition. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. Anybody can probably use the page turn effect. We'll go way beyond that and add lots of unique details and at the same time make it incredibly easy to control the animation of the transition. So let's get started. First of all, let's create a new comp, obviously. Transition, 1920 by 1080 pixels, 48 frames long. We add a new solid, footage 2. And we use the effects and presets window to add a gradient ramp. Let's change the direction of the ramp to diagonal. And let's use a very dark blue as start color. A dark purple as end color. Let's actually pretend this is the footage which will be revealed by the transition. And a text to remind us of that, footage 2. We quickly center it using the alignment tool. We need some more comps. The next one, footage 1. In this comp is the footage we slice up and flip. We copy the layers we just created and paste them to the footage comp. We change the text and quickly change the gradient colors. Dark blue becomes red. Purple becomes orange. Okay. Next, we need to split the footage 2 comp in an upper and lower part, as we want to slice through horizontally. Therefore, we create two new comps. Footage lower half, size 1920 by 540 pixels. We duplicate it, name it footage upper half. Next, we add the footage 2 comp to the lower half. The Y position should be 0. The lower half is visible. Then we add it to the upper half. The upper half of the footage comp is visible. The Y position is 540. And now let's go back to the main comp and set this up. We add the two halves to the transition comp and position them. We move the upper half up, Y 270 pixels. Lower half, 960 by 810 pixels, if my math is correct. And yes, the footage matches. Awesome. Next, we add CC page turn to both of them. The lower half and the upper half. Set the fold radius to 200, light direction minus 60 degrees, back page none, we want the color, back opacity 100%. Same for the upper half. We could have copied the effect as well, but whatever. One last thing we do right now is to set the controls. Upper half, bottom left corner. Lower half, bottom, bottom left corner. We leave everything as it is and add an adjustment layer. Name it controls in capitals because it's very important. Just kidding. Then we go to effect, expression controls and add a point control. Duplicate it, we need two, and a color control. We label them fold position lower half, fold position upper half, and paper color. Now we go into the effects property of the lower half comp. Open CC page turn, then select the adjustment layer and link the fold position to the lower half point control. We select the adjustment layer again and link the paper color to the paper color control. Of course, we repeat that for the upper half comp. We link the fold position and the paper color. So the expression controls literally control the transition now. That doesn't seem right. This one is fine. I think we chose the wrong control. Top left corner. That's it. Let's change the paper color to a dark purple. Awesome. Now, as we've set up the base, time to go way further. Let's duplicate the footage lower half comp. Rename it, footage lower half back page. Then we set the render setting in the CC page turn effect to back page. And add noise. Amount 15%. No color noise. This gives the back page a bit of a texture without affecting the footage. We repeat that for the footage upper half comp. Duplicate it, rename it, set the render setting to back page, and copy and paste the noise effect. The next thing we need is some depth. Simply adding a drop shadow wouldn't work, so I figured this out. We duplicate the footage lower half comp, rename it, footage lower half shade, and move it below the footage comp. Let's solo it to see what happens. We add fill and color everything black. Then we add directional blur. Direction 90 degrees, blur length around 200. And if we add the footage comp, there is shade, exactly where we need it, which is awesome. And you guessed it, we repeat that for the upper half. Awesome, much better already. If you like this video so far, please give it a like, I'd really appreciate it. Thanks very much, guys. I think we need one more layer of shade. Here, where the page is on top of each other. For this, we're gonna use the back page comp. We duplicate it, add shade to the layer name, and move it below. Solo it. Unsolo the other ones. We again add fill, color it black. Then we add directional blur again. Direction around 70 degrees should be fine. Length 150. Then we add Gaussian blur to soften it even more. Blurriness around 100. Let's move the noise effect to the bottom. And looking at it now, we see there's a problem. The left edge. There shouldn't be any of this shade, just to the right. To solve that, we use the set matte effect. And take the matte from the footage lower half comp, effects and masks, that's it. There's only one shade on the paper itself. And you probably know what's coming next. The upper half. We duplicate the shape, rename it, and simply copy and paste the effects. Adjust the direction of the blur, and we take the matte from the upper half comp. Awesome. All that's left to do now is to animate the two fold positions. We go to the beginning, set two keyframes for the positions, press U to see them in the timeline. We set the lower point to 0 and 0, the upper point to 0 and 1080. So it's all closed. Then we go to 24 frames, and let's zoom out here a little. Move them out of the screen so that the upper half, in this case, completely disappears. Seems good for me. And the lower half. We move that point way below the screen. Finally, we select the four keyframes, open the graph editor, and edit the speed graph. We slow down the beginning and the end of the animations. The animations don't have to be symmetrical. It's actually quite nice if they aren't. You still can change the timing by adjusting the speed curves. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell, because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this video. See you in the next one. Bye, guys.